Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome host of War Room, Steve Bannon.
Onward to victory! Onward to victory! Onward to victory! Is there anything going to stop us from winning on 5 November of 2024? I can't hear you. Is anything going to stop us? Today, in this very hall, the greatest president of the 20th and 21st century sat here and said he's a political dissident. He's persecuted. That is a mark upon our country because it's absolutely true, 100% true. And why is he a dissident? You know why? Because he gave us 3 years of peace and prosperity before he was hit with a Chinese bioweapon. And they stole the 2020 election. Media, I want you to suck on this. I want the White House to suck on this. You lost in 2020. Donald Trump is the legitimate president of the United States. Trump won. Trump won. Trump won. Trump won. Trump won. Trump won. You know how we know categorically that Trump won now? Because the New York Times and MSNBC and the Washington Post understand we're about to out them, right? We're going to adjudicate this after victory. If Biden actually won, he would be a revered hero to them. If Kamala Harris had really been the wingman, she'd be a revered hero. The New York Times is throwing Biden under the bus every day and backing him up over him. That shows you they know he's an illegitimate regime head. He's a usurper in 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. To every working class Democrat and populist in the Democratic Party, when we get to the White House and go through and adjudicate the fact that 2020 was stolen and this illegitimate regime, what they've done to destroy this country. Nobody that loved this country would do what he's doing to the country, would they? Would anybody think about it for a second? What if our framers came back here, came back today and saw 10 million illegal alien invaders that they have gamed the system to bring here? Nobody. Give me that again, ma'am. Lock them up. All of them. Garland, Ray, Biden, all of them. Mayorkas. What they did to this country is unforgivable. And we will not forget it, and we will never forgive it until justice is done. Now, some of our folks may say justice in this case is retribution. I will let that be defined as we go forward. But we're not going to back off this. President Donald J. Trump is the greatest president of the 20th and 21st century. Think about it for a second. When they stole the election and he went back to Mar-a-Lago, he could have played the game. He could have been part of the system. He could have gotten the big book deal and had the memorial films made about him and, you know, built more golf courses and had a life of leisure as a billionaire should have and deserve and with his beautiful family. What did he do? He came back to lead his country and say, I'm not going to let them steal this election and I'm not going to ever let them destroy the United States of America. Like the great Roman general, Cincinnatus, he has returned from the plow to save his country. Only two other men in the history of this republic General Washington in the Revolution and the Foundation, and Abraham Lincoln in the Civil War, have the personal fate and destiny of an individual be inextricably linked to the fate and destiny of this republic. Donald John Trump is the third person. And his fate and destiny is to have the greatest political comeback in American history. And on November 5th, to drive the vermin out of 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. Biden, you and your crime family are nothing but trash, okay? And on the 20th of January of 2025, we're gonna take out the trash. There's no compromise here. You, by 10 million illegal aliens, you got $35 trillion of debt, and you're not gonna stop $2 trillion of deficits a year. You've stumbled into a kinetic war in the Eurasian landmass. You got two carrier battle groups in the Red Sea protecting the elites of Europe and putting our sailors at risk. You've got a third world war. We got dead eye control. It's gonna destroy and bankrupt this republic. And you have an invasion of 10 million illegal alien invaders and migrant crimes out of control. And the people being destroyed are the black and Hispanic working class in this country, and we're not gonna allow it. Every black person, every Hispanic citizen in our country, vote for Trump. Trump will set you free, because right now, they're enslaving you. They call you racist, they call you xenophobe, they call you nativist. Nothing could be farther from the truth, because they can't win the intellectual argument. What they have to do is try to smear you. And you don't care, because you know that's not true, and the facts are not true. The facts are not true. And that is what Trump's program is. That's his biggest crime. You know his biggest crime? You know why they want to send him to prison for 700 years? You know why they want to bankrupt him, take all his money away, $500 million what? Fine right now? Take him off the ballot, defamation charges every day, all over the place, from Atlanta to D.C. You heard Peter Navarro lay it all out. You know what his crime is, and not the things they're charging him with. That's all crap, and you know it's crap, and they know it's crap. His crime is that he put you in the room. In D.C., in the imperial capital, not in the room, not in the deal. He put the American working man and woman in the room and at the head of the table, and they hate him for it. They think he's a traitor to the ruling class of this country. You've seen with the Sound of Freedom folks up here and throughout the day, throughout the week, the crimes, not just of this administration, but the crimes of the Federal Reserve, the crimes of the big investment banks, the overlords of easy money on Wall Street, the tech oligarchs, the combination that think they're the ruling class in this country. Well, Donald Trump and the MAGA movement say you're not. And on November 5th, we're gonna have an up or down vote on that. And my money is on the American people and the MAGA movement and Donald John Trump to turf you out and to break your grip on the greatest nation on earth. This is a crusade of righteousness. Are you with us? Are you with us? Are we onward to victory? Will anything stop you?
No.
Are you onward to victory?
Yes.
Are you onward to victory?
Yes.
Are you onward to victory?
Yes.
When you set out to take Vienna, take Vienna. Thank you.